they have to answer. No, you are not planning. At the spot, what comes in your mind, you are saying. This is called as creative idea. It's a negative only, but you have the capacity. Yes, you have the capacity to solve the problem at a second without making a plan and adopt new ideas. Analyze multiple view of thoughts. Today, in the absence of your class, your sister is asking why you have to the class. You are saying, I got fever. Second day, again you are asking, why? I got stomach fever. So, you are analyzing multiple view of thoughts. Right? Yes or no? Adopt ideas and arrive at new solutions. Sometimes it is referred to as divergent thinking. Strategies can be introduced using direct instruct in creative problem solving models and creative thinking process. The creative idea should be fluency, flexibility, and originality with elaboration. Your idea, first, you have to think. You have to clear with your ideas. You have to elaborate your ideas. The idea should be flexible for yourself. The idea should be fluency. If you are not clear with your idea, how can others be clear? Yes? So, while preparing a solution for a problem, you have to clear. You have to be clear because it is creating. You are creating the solution. It's your solution. So you have to first clear, then you have to make others to clear. What is the difference between creativity and innovation? No difference, they both are. So what is creativity and innovation? Knowledge, motivation, and thinking. These three combined together is called as creativity. What is knowledge? What is motivation? And what is thinking? So already I said, motivation is the beginning for each and every action. So motivation, the willingness to exert effort to reach organization goals, conditioned by the efforts, ability to satisfy such individual goals. The point is, the willingness to exert effort to reach organization goals, conditioned by the efforts, ability to satisfy some individual needs. Who is referred to the individual goal? You. We are all putting an effort to satisfy you. We are putting effort as a motivation to satisfy you. It's my job, okay? I am coming in my own interest to motivate you. No one is pushing me to, you just go and motivate the students. You just go and motivate me. It's my own interest. Yes? Why I am coming here to motivate you? To satisfy you. So motivation works best when individual needs are compatible with organization's goals. If a person without any goal, that is any use to motivating? Yes? If you are not a cricket player, I am coming and saying, you should become a big batsman, big player, big bowler. Is there any use? No. So first, you have to fix the goal. By the goal, you will motivate. Next. Going to the next point. Defining knowledge. What is knowledge? Every classroom stand that word in it, right? Like one, knowledge is power, right?
Yeah.
How many of you saw that? Just raise your hands. Knowledge is power. All are sleeping? Yes? Please adjust for 30 minutes, okay? Just raise your hands. How many saw knowledge is power? Yes. Can you explain what is knowledge is power? What is knowledge? Knowledge is understanding, gained from experience, analysis, and sharing. If I ask a person to touch the flame of lamp, okay? You just go and touch the flame of lamp. Will you touch? Will you touch? Why? You know that it will injure your finger. How do you know that? By experience, right? You have some experience by touching the flame. Second, analyze. You think, oh, fire is key. So if I keep the finger, it will injure you. This is called sharing. Someone will say to you, no, no, don't touch. Already I have the experience, so don't touch. This is called knowledge. just coming to the God, without my knowledge, I did this mistake. What does it mean? Without my knowledge, I did this mistake. That means we have no experience in that mistake. We have no analysis or no sharing. These three, if not means, you are saying that without my knowledge. With your knowledge means you have the experience, you have the analysis, and you have the sharing. So knowledge is information combined with experience, context, interpretation, and reflection. Knowledge is the information analyzed to provide meaning and value or evaluated as to implications for the operation. It is also comprehension gained from study, experience, practice, and human interaction. Yeah, what is it? Experience and study. By studying is called as analyzing. Yes, without the study, you can't analyze. Practice and human interaction. Human interaction means sharing. In work, you friends are talking to you, what do you say? You don't work with that person. It's very graphic. This is called as sharing. Okay. Your friend is experiencing the traffic. You are getting the sharing from your friend. Clear? This is called as knowledge. Okay. Next, moving to the next point. What do you mean by thinking skill? How many of them know what is thinking skill? No one? No one knows what is thinking skill? Nothing, just thinking. Planning is called as thinking skill. Just I'm asking, explain about algebra. Or explain the derivation about Adam Smith theory. How many of them know Adam Smith theory?
Anyone?
How many of them know what is standard deviation?
Do battery.
What is standard deviation?
Battery.
Where is? Are you sleeping? Just ask yes or no. How many of them know standard deviation? I know, I just raised my hand. How many of them know? No math students? People, you are not saying what you know or you are not explaining standard deviation because you are very bad. Because they are not leading to your program. Right? Thus, without any harder, you can't get there. So please wait for a few minutes and you will hear. So thinking skill or cognitive process enable us to make meaning from creative information. Everyone has the knowledge of thinking. You only go with the knowledge of some subjects. That's all. Discarding, analyzing, staying. That this is called how to behave and how not to behave. How to behave in a public and how to behave in a private. Because you have a thinking skill. Where I will push you and where I will teach you. If you are creative, you can do that. Okay.
It's just
firstly connected without any prejudice or any special order. Prejudice means what? If your friend is saying, yes, I have this idea, but you are saying, no, no, this will not work out. No, it's rejected. You should not say like that. Okay, first you have to listen. Whatever your friends are saying, you have to listen. Without that, you say, no, this is not, that's not good. No, I will not accept it. This will not work out. You should not say any negative comments. Okay, just you have to listen what your friends are saying, then you have to make a law. Make a log in that, and then your group members and collect it. Clear? Gathering the words from your group members and collecting it is called as word bank. Next, scamper. Scamper means S-C-M-P-E-R. S for substitute, C for combine, A for adapt or alter, M for modify, P for put another use, E for eliminate, and R for invest. For a small example, you know the copycat songs, yes? What they are doing? They are keeping the substitute song and they are combining with other music and they are adapting or altering that. They are modifying that song, they are putting it to the another use, they eliminate the unwanted words and reverse the same song in the use. Yes? And that song is becoming viral. This is called a scammer. Simple example. The scammer is an acronym that provides a structured way of assisting students to think out of the box and enhance their knowledge. Next, what is SWOT analysis? SWOT means what? S for strength, W for weakness, O for opportunities, and T for threats. Every person should think, what is your SWOT? What is your strength? What is your weakness? What is your opposite and opposite? Too long or too hard. Okay? What do you feel about the suggestion? What are your gut reactions? What intuition do you have? And don't think too long or too hard. This is called as red hat. Okay. Now we can see white hat. White hat represents the information seeking hat. What are the facts? What information is available? What is relevant? When wearing the white hat, we are neutral in our thinking. We are neutral in our thinking. We are balanced in our thinking. So this is called as white hat. And next, yellow hat. What is the meaning of yellow hat? What is it? What is the meaning of yellow hat? Any idea? The sunshine hat. Yellow hat means what? The sunshine hat. It is a positive and constructive. It is a positive and constructive. Next, it is about effectiveness and getting a job done. It says what are the benefits and advantages of the yellow hat. This is called as yellow. Next, black hat. Black hat, what comes in your mind first? Black hat means what comes in your mind first? The caution hat. Yes? Black hat, what the caution hat? In black hat, the sticker points out errors and pitfalls. He will just pinpoint the black marks. He will pinpoint the negatives in that idea. This is called as black hat. So what are the risks or dangers involved? Identify difficulties and problems is called as black hat. Next, we come to green hat. Green hat is a creative person. Green hat is a creative person. This is a creative mode of thinking. Green represents the growth and movement. In green hat, we look for new ideas and solutions. Okay? Clear? Next, blue hat. Blue hat represents the control that hat organizing thinking itself, sets a focus points for the use of other hats, monitors and reflects on the thinking process. So this is called as blue hat. So the seven hats have been over. Next, we come to our next point, zero graph. What is zero graph? What is zero graph? Just by giving a paper and pen and asking you to write about Chennai. What is Chennai? First, what is it? What is Chennai? Chennai is the capital of Tamil Nadu. Then, any related to your research topic or question. It is more or less intricate piece of writing that flows quickly from your mind as you reflect upon your topic, your question and your reading. Dear God is focused on free writing or the very next step. Next word is brain editing. In your group members, if there is any shy person, is there? The person is which is shy. You should not work in it because group discussion is only for creating the solution. It's not to make it the girl to be a motivated to come out of the shyness. So you have to go ahead, you have to make that girl, if you are shy, no issue. Just mail to me. Okay? You must ask their ideas also. So brain editing tools from simple to sophisticated, the very simplest form of brain editing which can be used both for virtual teams and for the teams that include shy or reticent members, ask team members to email their members to the location. Next, last, question assumption. What is question assumption? What is question assumption? A close examination of a research topic or argument requires that you establish the key facts and important issue concerning the topic or argument by looking at them in close detail. This means that you must adopt a very critical approach to examine a question. Next, the three main tools of brainstorming. First, no criticism, arguing or negative comments. Second, complete log. Third, think outside the box and inspire each other. Clear? Everyone are clear? Now you know what is creating? Yes? It's helpful to you? Okay. We should clear something.
Yeah, exactly.